Gemini, it's me, Stormy, and here is your January 2020 horoscope. Welcome to the brand new year. I look forward to walking with you every week, every month, through all the good stuff that's going on. So let's get ready to jump into what's happening for you in January. But before we jump in, there is still your last minute chances to get signed up for the Astrology Hub free forecast marathon that is coming up January 9th through the 12th. 12 different astrologers getting ready to teach you about what's coming in 2020, how to walk through that, what are your best timings, resources, all of that good stuff. So if you want to sign up, the link is in the description box down below, and I look forward to seeing you over there. It'll be such a good time. All right, Gemini, this month, it's actually a really interesting month because we've got the eclipse happening, we've got Saturn and Pluto coming together in their conjunction, Uranus is coming out of retrograde this month, as well, you have got some career opportunities that seem really nice and available to you. So let's jump in and talk about what this looks like. All right, first and foremost, at the beginning of the month, we have got Jupiter and Mercury coming together in the conjunction here in your eighth house. So as you can see, the eighth house is pretty loaded for you this month, and it will continue to be pretty loaded for the year. But as we're looking here in January, we see Jupiter and Mercury, first of all, in this conjunction in this eighth house. Now, this is brilliant because what this means for you is the planet of expansion, Jupiter, is coming together with the other planet of communication, Mercury. And as they're together sharing this energy, it is giving you an idea of resources or structures, an idea around something you need to communicate. Now, this could also pull a communication in for you with someone that you share a joint resource with, or someone, I don't like to use the word codependent, but if there is a relationship that is, you're tied to a bank, you're tied to parents, you're tied to a partner, you're tied to a grant or a sponsorship, wherever there is an interaction or dependence with you and someone else, this could be giving you some ideas or some serious communications about maybe what needs to be different, maybe an opportunity that's coming along or something like that. Now, on the third, what's going to happen is Mars going to leave this Scorpio energy, and he's going to move up here into the energy of Sagittarius. Now, this is your relationship zone, okay? So with the events that have happened on the second to the Mars movement on the third, one of the things I continue to think about, especially until February, is that Mars is Mars, right? He's assertive, he's aggressive, he sometimes brings a little bit of conflict to the table. So this could be a conflicting conversation that is happening this month. Maybe you and someone that you have resources with, intimacy with, maybe there's a fear or a trauma you're starting to work on and work out right here at the beginning of the year so that you can release it, because ultimately the idea here with this being such a heavy Sagittarian year is that you've got to have your structures in the right order and in the right place, because you need the ones that you need in order to be successful. So Mars could bring a conversation, could bring an argument about resources. It could also just bring some sexy back to your relationships, right? Action, movement, momentum. If this happens to be a positive aspect for you in your chart, this could bring a beautiful business or friendship, significant relationship to your table, and it's got a lot of movement to it. Sagittarius is going to bring in maybe a different or more open-minded kind of energy. Maybe culturally you're interacting with someone different. Maybe even within your own family, you have different cultural views on what should be happening. So look out for Mars until February to definitely be bringing some action to your table that is about unearthing what needs to be there and making sure that these structures and the actions around them are solid for you, okay? On the 8th, we're going to have Jupiter doing kind of a cool thing, and I'll be making a little touch-in on this as we continue through the week. Jupiter is actually going to come into conjunction with the South Node on the 8th. This is important because as we're here and we're getting ready for the year and the moons and planting our seeds of intention, as Jupiter and the South Node travel in conjunction with each other, they're saying, hey, we are looking over and bringing wisdom and bringing new beliefs to something from the past, right? This is a past karmic, has already been here because we've been looking for it at least a year. We've been looking at it for at least a year kind of energy. So I would tell you, it's not the best time before this eclipse to be setting intentions for something new. Instead, this is a very, very good evaluation place. What's been going on? What's been happening? What behaviors have you been playing out in your joint resources? Do you need to cut someone off? Do you need to cut yourself off from someone or a resource in order to gain your own freedom and independence, right? Use the 8th as that particular energy. Now, as we do pop forward to the 10th, we're gonna see that we've got this full moon lunar eclipse happening at 20 degrees of Cancer. So we're gonna have this bad boy, it's at 20 degrees. So just right across the house. Both of your resource houses are lit up, right? The 8th house is heavy over here. We get a big old dose of energy to kind of balance out this 2nd house over here. Now, with the lunar eclipse being in your 2nd house, it tells me that for the next 6 months around your finances, something has to end. Something has to be adjusted. You've got to make some kind of acknowledgement in order to make an abundant opportunity for financial gain for yourself. And this is also a placement of self-esteem, self-confidence, which balancing out on the other side, it's saying, hey, I need you to see a little bit of independence so you can make your own way, right? Or what's our plan for entering into a sound joint connection so that ultimately we can have our own freedom on the other side, right? And remember, a lot of this will be coming through the lens of relationships as well because Mars is still floating in that 7th house, okay? So with this particular energy, we know that your finances are going to see a shift in this next 6 months, and it is likely the adjustments being made are so that you can be successful here. This is a helpful energy. Now, on the 11th, one of the things that's going to happen is that Uranus is going to come out of retrograde in the energy here of Taurus, which is going to light up your 12th house. With Uranus out of retrograde, he's our change maker, right? He's come in, he shakes you out of your comfort zone, and he's like, ah, these structures will not work. We need something fresh here. So Uranus coming out of your 12th house, he has been here since August saying, all right, Gemini, I need you to relook at some fears you've got going on, some guilt, some shame, some resentments, anything that's been hidden. I need you to look at your spiritual teachings, your spiritual practices, anything that needs to transition out. Uranus has been over here working on your past to help you. So now as he comes forward and is direct again, Uranus is going to travel in that forward motion so that you can understand what needs to be changed in this 12th house and what do you need to keep. Right? Did you have that plan or that project from the past and it's been trying to make its way forward, Gemini? And it's going to say, yes, make some adjustments, but let's keep that so that as we move forward, that's your brilliant new thing you have to offer to this age of Aquarius that is coming very quickly as we travel 2020. Is it saying, hey, let's go ahead and let go of some of this fear because it's not actually serving us? Is it saying, yes, I think that you should be teaching yoga or anything spiritual? Yes, you should take that job in mental health nursing, right? Like, what is this Uranian energy been pointing you to? And you'll know because you've been working on it or feeling it or been accustomed to feeling uncomfortable with it since August of 2019. So think back, okay? All right, the other thing happening on the 11th, obviously, is the Saturn-Pluto conjunction that's also going to be happening right up here in your 8th house. Now, because the Saturn-Pluto conjunction, and it'll be on the 11th or the 12th, just depending on where you live, okay? Because the Saturn and Pluto conjunction is such a slow evolutionary change and advancement for us, what it can feel like is loss. Right? It can feel like loss. Now, some people, depending on your chart, it'll feel like, oh, this is your saving grace. Thank God for the help, right? But sometimes it can feel like loss. And what it's saying is, I need you to grow and I need you to advance here so that I can take you to the next level, especially in your money. But sometimes we have to have that feeling of loss to see what we need to adjust in order to move forward, right? So I want to tell you that right out front. So if you're kind of like, whoa, what happened? There's like a little vacuum has happened in my life. The universe never leaves a hole. Absolutely never leaves a hole. And you're going to get some help and support on the 13th to see how to fill that hole for yourself. As we get to the 13th, Venus is going to take her move out of the energy of Aquarius and move into the energy of Pisces. Hello, Gemini. This is for you. Okay. Venus here in your 10th house is offering you a brilliant career opportunity. This is something that is going to be yours, or it is something that even if connected to a joint resource, you're getting the opportunity to manage this in a way that is right, that is correct, that is intuitively sound for you. Now, I will tell you too, for some of you Geminis, I'm getting the sense with all of this 8th house connection going on, you may, let's say that you're going into someone else's business or you're looking over your own books, it's the beginning of the year, you may discover something that was missing, right? It's up to here traveling with Neptune, and certainly as we get towards the end of the month, you may be like, oh, these numbers don't budget out correctly. Oh, something is missing. But there is also a beautiful intuitive space for you to clean up anything that's been missing here in the career area, which gives you this fresh start that we've been looking for with this lunar eclipse as well. So anything that needs to be cleaned up, debt, deficit, anything like that, this Venus energy here is going to help you. Now, as we get to the 16th, we're going to see Mercury prepared to move on, and he's going to move over here into the energy of Aquarius. Then we see the Sun moving on into the energy of Aquarius. And then we're going to have a new moon happening in the energy of Aquarius. So now the 9th house is getting a little bit busy. The 9th house, publishing, broadcasting, expanding with Mercury here, with the Sun here, with this new moon happening here. This is an encouragement of new thinking, fresh thinking, open-minded thinking, original thinking. Maybe you have to think around the rules. Maybe you've discovered some information that helps you make decisions about how to expand this business, how to expand your opportunities to make money, how to expand you out into the world. At this new moon, because it's in the energy of Aquarius, remember, at the new moon, at all new moons we're going to have besides the eclipses, you're going to want to plant your seeds of intention. What would you like to begin here? In your area of expansion, Gemini, where do you want your independence to be? Where is the importance of your independence critical? You have some shine here with Venus in this 10th house. So it tells me in a very public way, you're able to be making some changes in these areas that ultimately will benefit you. So think about it like this. In your connections with other people, whether it be professional or whether it be private, right? You have these happy opportunities with Venus up here to make progress forward. But what new thinking has got to come to the table in order for you to get out of the maybe feeling tied down that you've been feeling for just a little bit? This will also trigger maybe some opportunities to expand a business into maybe international business in some way, shape, or form. But ultimately, the Saturn-Pluto conjunction will show you how to take care of all of these things because it will stimulate the information from within. All right, two dates I want to bring to your attention. January 27th, I briefly touched on this. What's going to happen is that Venus and Neptune are going to be traveling together in conjunction up there in the 10th house. I love these two together. They're the Bopsy twins. Everything is so blissful when they're there. It is really a place where if you've been feeling it intuitively or you've kind of been thinking it or dreaming it, it's like you just magnetize it into your life. It is absolutely scrumptious and delicious. I love it. But it is not necessarily the most clear information. So if there are things happening in your 10th house, your business connected with other people, big business decisions that need to be made, I would ask you to proceed in these last couple days of January with caution, because those two are so delicious together, they actually create a little bit of fog as well. So you might not have all of the information. Instead, information could be being revealed to you that you need moving forward. Now on the 28th, we've got Mars, who's here in Sagittarius, and he is going to take on and square Neptune here in Pisces. So now the square is good news for us. It doesn't always feel great, but it is good news for us because the square is the 911. It says, hey, Gemini, I need you to take action. I need you to move. So something between a relationship with work, 7th house, 10th house, is going to come together. And this is a place where you maybe have to acknowledge a mistake that you've made. Maybe there's been overdependence. Maybe there's been, you know, truthfully with Neptune and Venus together, where's the gossip? Have you been gossiped about or something like that? Information about your name may be having a little bit of a struggle here, but the square is going to activate you into action. Mars is involved here. You could go create a conflict. Yes, you could. But you could also, Gemini up, throw those shoulders back and be like, yep, I made that mistake. Let me clean that up. Or if you're having to go in and deal with other people, I would highly suggest to you, don't go in, you know, just balls to the walls, ready to take someone down. Remember that there is honesty, there is truth. It's never gonna be different, but it doesn't always have to be brutal. It needs to be rigorous. We need the truth. We don't need to damage each other. So whatever you're confronting here in this particular area, oh, and for some people, this could be a shift just in a relationship. This could be telling you, you need to make a different decision in a connection to a relationship. So whoever that is for, that was very specific. So that is for you, okay? But that again is a day where I would tell you the fog is not entirely lifted. So just be a little bit mindful with what you're doing and how you're reacting to things, okay? All right, Gemini, I think it's gonna be a brilliant January. I really do. The career opportunities, the cleanup is here for whatever you need so that you can move free moving forward. So please keep me posted in the comment section down below how this is materializing for you. It's going to be a good month. Ask questions. Don't travel alone. And I look forward to seeing you around the channel. And of course, at the free forecast marathon coming up just January 12th, okay? I love you guys so much. I'll see you in the next video. Bye, gems.